Hi, welcome back to everyone. With this prevalence of coronavirus, a lot of updates are coming up with COVID-19. So let us see the recent article published in RSNA, that is CORADS, that is COVID-19 Reporting and Data System. So let us see what this research article says. And the main purpose of this research article was done to introduce the COVID-19 reporting and data system, that is CORADS, and to assess the pulmonary involvement of COVID-19 in non-enhanced CT chest, and its initial inter-observer agreement was performed. So it was categorized like this: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and level of suspicion as not interpretable, very low, low, equivocal, high, very high, and proven case of COVID-19. So let us see in brief about all these classification system. Coming to the typical features before going into CORADS, these features are very much important in categorizing into CORADS. The obligatory features are the ground glass opacities with or without consolidations in lung regions close to the visceral pleural surfaces, including the fissures. The second point is the multifocal bilateral distribution. And the confirmatory patterns are the ground glass regions, which are unsharp demarcation, half round shaped sharp demarcation with outlining shape of multiple adjacent secondary pulmonary nodules. And the third one is the crazy paving pattern, the organizing pneumonia pattern, and the thickened vessels within the parenchymal abnormality in all confirmatory patterns. So presence of thickened vessels is also a pattern of confirmation in COVID-19. So let us see what is CORADS 0. It's nothing but an incomplete scan or insufficient quality due to breathing or coughing. Coming to CORADS 1, very low suspicion level, presence of mild or severe emphysema, perifissural nodules, lung tumors or fibrosis. So all these are non-specific for COVID-19. So we categorize it under very low level of suspicion. Coming to CORADS 2, low level of suspicion, that is, the features of typical for infectious etiology, but not compatible with COVID-19 features, which I already explained all the patterns of COVID-19. And this comes under atypical appearance of RSNA consensus statement. And these are the few exceptions which you can read in the article, which come under CORADS 2. And this is the classical example of dilated bronchi with thickened bronchial walls in chronic bronchitis combined with the train bud pattern, indicative of infectious bronchiolitis, that is not specific for COVID-19 again, and another image showing the consolidation in lobar pattern. This comes under CORADS 2. Coming to CORADS 3, it's nothing but equivocal findings of lung involvement. Findings can be present in other viral etiologies or other non-infectious etiologies. So these findings have a lot of overlap with viral as well as non-infectious etiologies. What are those? Perihilar ground glassing, extensive ground glassing, or ground glass with interlobular septal thickening, and the pattern of consolidation in organizing pneumonias. So all these patterns or features come under CORADS 3. And the most important, in the absence of typical CT findings, there should not be any typical CT finding apart in the presence of these above findings, will come under CORADS 3. And this CORADS 3 comes under indeterminate appearance of RSNA consensus statement. Coming to example of CORADS 3, that is the single focus, this is an RT-PCR positive patient showing a single focal of ground glass opacity, and this is the ground glass opacities with superimposed consolidations in central lobular pattern. So this comes under CORADS 3 in RT-PCR negative patient. What is CORADS 4? High level suspicion of pulmonary involvement comes under CORADS 4. Typical CT features of COVID-19 with some overlap of other viral pneumonias. Similar to CORADS 5, but not in contact with the visceral pleura or strictly unilateral or superimposed on severe diffuse pre-existing pulmonary abnormality. So this is very important, which comes under CORADS 4. And these CORADS 4 is again under indeterminate appearance category of RSNA consensus statement. And this is an example of CORADS 4. You can see this is the positive patient, this is the negative. This is also the positive patient showing the ground glass superimposed on severe central lobular emphysema. You can see the emphysematous changes on the background of normal lung as well as abnormal lung. You can see here, visceral pleural contact is present. You can see here the interlobular septal thickening as well, in which is unsharply demarcated. This comes under Coriat's 4. What is Coriat's 5? Very high level of suspicion. Mandatory features are ground glass opacities close to the visceral pleura and bilateral multifocal involvement. Subpleural sparing is allowed. Sparing can be present. So it means that sparing may be present in Coriat's 5. And this Coriat's 5 can have a temporal resolution of GGOs to crazy paving to consolidation, and then to organizing pneumonia pattern. And presence of subpleural curvilinear bands and bands of GGO with tethered pattern or arching pattern is considered typical for Coriat's 5. And this Coriat's 5 comes under typical appearance of RSNA consensus statement. What is Coriat's 6? Nothing but proven case of COVID-19 with RT-PCR. Comes under Coriat's 6, similar to the BI-RADS 6 in BI-RADS. That is a breast imaging. So the conclusion of the article is developed by Dutch Radiological Society. It provides the framework which helps in reporting schemes for COVID-19. And it expands the concept in a way similar to the lung rats, and it has provided categories of suspicion for pulmonary involvement in non-contrast chest CT. So everyone can go through this article, which is available in RSNA website, and it's accessible free. Thank you, everyone.